guess this is like the tune in to watch Leah cry for 5 minutes show. I'm so sorry. This one, though, I can't help it. Hey, pals. Welcome to Life with Leah the Makeup Mama. I'm Leah. I'm a professional makeup artist. I'm a mama. This is my life. So it's Soulful Source. Today is Soulful Storytime Sunday, part two. And we're talking about infertility, just a little bit. There's so much to say. I don't know. We're just gonna touch. Have a little moment. You ready? Yeah? I'm very, very, very grateful and honored to get the privilege to be the mom to like the two most amazing little humans I've ever met. It's kind of astounding. Let's start with that. So, when I was 17, this is gonna be hard because I'm like crying, but there's a baby in the background. This is real, real, real life. When I was 17, I was diagnosed with an infertility condition, and I feel like at that time in your life, you're really young and you don't quite exactly realize what that means, but I did. I knew. I felt the weight of it, and it was a really big thing, and it was a weird thing, and you're young and you're in high school, and like, I feel like people think that you're trying to get attention or something like that, but this was really going on in my life and was really hard, and I didn't exactly have words for it. I still maybe don't exactly, but I was told then that there would be like a less than 1% chance that I would ever get pregnant. So 99.9% that I would never, ever get pregnant. So Brandon and I started dating. I told him, and his response was that we would adopt, and like he didn't blink an eye. I think one of the things about infertility, like as a woman, is your worth and value, and we're told like it doesn't matter what culture you grew up in or what dynamic you grow up in, you're told that like this is a woman's strength and power and gift, and then to not have it is really weird and hard. And I didn't know if anyone would love me, and that's so weird and dumb, but like, that's a recurring theme in my life, and this was one big way that Brandon being who he is, which I hope that you've watched our past couple of Brandon videos, go back and watch them. He's amazing, but him being who he is just so affirmed me and loved me. It didn't matter. Like, he knew that's okay, we're still gonna be parents. Like, it wasn't like, it wasn't even a maybe we're just a couple. Like, he immediately went to, we'll just adopt. So we got married knowing that that would be our path someday. When we were very first married, we got to go on a really cool adventure and go live in a different country for a few years. We lived up in Northern Canada. It was amazing. But there was a lot of heartache and a lot of hard things that happened through that. And one of them was that we got pregnant. We got pregnant, and pretty far into the pregnancy, I lost the baby and like held a baby, labored a child. And like the devastation that emotionally and mentally and the mental health and all of that junk that Brandon and I both went through over the next few years was so just crazy. Like, I didn't think we would ever be us again. It felt like something in me died because something in me died, but like, it felt like I was gone. So, that's such a weird thing to say. If you've ever lost a child, I feel like whether you've lost a child early in a pregnancy, whether you lost a child at 18, when they were 18, there's something about knowing that someone's not here that should be here, is missing, is so weird. And like off-putting. Thank goodness that's not the end of our story. Thank goodness that's not the end of our story. We thought that it would be. We thought that was it. Can I have Kleenex or something? I'm like a mess. Sorry, y'all. I guess this is like the tune in to watch Leah cry for 5 minutes show. I'm so sorry. This one though, I can't help it. As a child, if you grew up in the South, or maybe tell me if this is how it is where you are, but as a child, you're told to dry it up and get over it, but it's so much healthier to just feel it in that moment. Don't be afraid of it. It's a lot scarier to just let it sit there and fester and then you freak out. So, we lost a baby. We didn't think it was ever gonna happen. And then we came back to North Carolina and had just an amazing support system and a group and community of people that we love so much that just rallied around us and believed in us and believed in family and wanted to help us do this crazy thing called adoption. And for us, that was a really full circle moment because that was always our plan A. Honestly, we feel like we got derailed for a few years. So we started the adoption process and now we have these two beautiful babies. That's not what this video is about, the adoption process. And it's not even about a timeline. And it's not even about our story, it's about infertility. Infertility is so hard because we're told that it's the thing that we can do, like as women. Infertility has been not a secret at all ever for me. It's not ever anything that I ever tried to hide. It's devastating and it's lonely. And especially if you're someone like me that grew up just loving children and always knowing that you wanted to be a mom. Like, any time that I would think 5 years in the future it had kids, like no matter how old I was, like even if I wasn't old enough to be thinking that, I was thinking that. I've just always loved children and always knew that I wanted to be a mom, and infertility is the devastation that your body just doesn't do what it's supposed to do. And wherever you are in that process, I'm so sorry. And you're not alone. And there is hope. And I don't know what that hope is, and I don't want to sell you a false book and a false, you know, formula to happiness, because I don't think that that's real either. What I can tell you is you're not alone. 1 in 8 couples have trouble getting pregnant or sustaining a pregnancy. 7.4 million women, 11.9% of women have ever received any infertility services in their lifetime. It's not just you. You're not alone. There's so much more to say. I feel like I just really rambled and was all over the place, and I'm really sorry. But it's been a big part of my life and our story. It still is. Let's talk about it. Let's get this out in the open. Let's not have any shame. There's no shame. I didn't do anything to make my body not work. It's not my fault. So why am I ashamed of it? Why don't I talk about it? Why is it such a big taboo? Let's take that stigma away. Wherever you are, I'm with you. I love you. You're enough. The hopes and dreams that you have for your life, I really believe, are just around the corner. They might look differently than you think, but if you take every day and be grateful and open your eyes, you're going to see it. You're going to see it. So I love you so much. Thank you so much for watching. I hope that you enjoyed this. This was hard for me. I feel like I was way all over the place. Come back next week. See what all we have. Please subscribe. If you're on Facebook, give us a page like and share and comment and talk to me. If you are on YouTube, subscribe to our channel, give us a thumbs up, turn on the notification bell, and comment. And if this goes on Instagram TV, then hello to you, Instagram world. Okay, thanks, pals. Love y'all.